Chancellor, the Most Reverend Dr. Peter Machado, and also Vice Chancellor, the Most Reverend Dr. Lawrence Pius, expressed clearly their desire that on occasions other members of the Board of Administration could also be invited to St. Peter's Pontifical Seminary and Institute. And so we have different bishops for the different occasions of our seminary and institute. Today we are delighted to have the Most Reverend Dr. Peter Paul Saldana, the Bishop of Mangalore and the member of the Board of Administration of St. Peter's Pontifical Seminary Institute. He is here today to be the chief celebrant and to be the speaker of the inaugural address. His Excellency was kind enough to accept our invitation when I invited him last March. In spite of his hectic schedule in his diocese, he consented happily and he is here with us to pray for us. We are also happy to have with us our Vice Chancellor, beloved Bishop, the Most Reverend Dr. Lawrence Pius, whose support is always assured to us, whose presence is a great source of strength to us. And we are also happy to have with us in our midst the Most Reverend Dr. Anthony Swami Francis, Bishop Emeritus of Kumbakonam, former member of the Board of Administration, to pray for us and to invoke God's blessings for us. My dear friends, the academic years 2024-25 and 2025-26 are very significant for our institute, because on 6th January 2025, the institute enters into its 50th year of its erection. And that will go for a year. Therefore, these two academic years are very important for us. How appropriate it is that we have three bishops closely connected to our institute to invoke the blessings of the Spirit in a special way for our entire institute. As St. Augustine says in today's second reading, we are Christians, and the second calling, we are also placed in charge. We are here to listen as shepherds, human shepherds. We are here to learn so that we may be able to guide the sheep who will be entrusted to our care by the Lord. We need the spirit of listening. We need the spirit of understanding very crucially. And so we are gathered here around this Eucharistic altar. Our bishop's blessings are assured. We can be sure about the blessings of our three shepherds. Let us continue to participate in this Eucharist. I, on behalf of Very Reverend Father Richard Berto, the rector, the officials and academic authorities of the institute, and the distinguished professors, the staff and students, happily invite all the three shepherds to invoke God's blessings for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
I thank Father Lawrence and the rector, all the fathers here, the bishops here, for having invited us to celebrate with you. God is with us through His Spirit. Let us, brothers and sisters, acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison, Glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father.
You take away
the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer, seated at the right hand. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Amen. Let us pray. O God, who have taught the hearts of the faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit, grant that in the same Spirit we may be truly wise and ever rejoice in His consolation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On that day, there shall come forth a shoot from the stump of Jesse, and a branch from his roots shall bear fruit. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. And his delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Lord, send forth your Spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Lord, send forth your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send forth your Spirit.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, how great you are. Clothed in majesty and honor, wrapped in light and sweet aroma.
Lord, save all your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth.
How many are your works, O Lord? In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Lord, send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send forth your spirit and renew the face of the
Sing hallelujah, sing, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing, sing, sing hallelujah, sing, sing hallelujah, sing, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing, 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 sing hallelujah.
The Spirit of Truth will bear witness about me, says the Lord. You also will bear witness.
Sing, sing hallelujah, sing, sing hallelujah, sing, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing, sing, sing hallelujah, sing. Sing hallelujah, sing, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing, sing, sing hallelujah, sing, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing hallelujah, sing, sing hallelujah, 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 sing.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O
At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Helper comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of Truth, who proceeds from the Father, he will bear witness about me. And you also will bear witness, because you have been with me from the beginning. I have said all these things to you to keep you from falling away. They will put you out of the synagogues. Indeed, the hour is coming when whoever kills you will think he is offering service to God, and they will do these things because they have not known the Father nor me. But I have said these things to you, that when their hour comes, you may remember that I told them to you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, in the law courts, lawyers plead on behalf of the plaintiff or defendant. They stand by the side of the accuser or the accused. Their only aim is to speak on behalf of their clients, because they have hired them. Finding out all the possible laws and applying them as and when the time permits or they are needed to be applied. All of them want to come to the truth, but many times the truth does not prevail, as we know the practice of justice in our times many times is all settings. They call settings now. They set the judge, and the lawyers become the mediators, and there are others. Slogans like Satyameva Jayate are written on the courts. The truth will win or prevail. But that's not always the case. Contrary to the way of the world, the Lord has something else to give, which the world does not give. He gives another paraclete, another advocate, a lawyer who will stand by us, who will be within us, and he will be with us always to plead our cause, to bear testimony to Christ, and will help us to bear testimony to Him. This Holy Spirit pleads before the Father on our behalf. The Lord said, I will give you another paraclete. And this paraclete, another, would mean there is one already. Jesus Himself is the advocate who pleads for us, intercedes for us before the Father incessantly. Peter in the house of Cornelius declares that Jesus was anointed by the Father with the Holy Spirit and power. And the Lord performed His deeds, great works of mercy, great signs to the power
of the Holy Spirit. And also these acts or works confirmed the truthfulness of the teaching of the kingdom. The disciples at the road to Emmaus described the perception of Jesus as a prophet, powerful in word and deed before God and all the people. And Saint Peter on the day of Pentecost proclaimed that Jesus was a man accredited by God to you by miracles, wonders and signs which God did among you through him. Conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, living a life fully led by the Spirit, as a man, Jesus was assisted by the Spirit, visibly descending upon him in the form of a dove and remaining with him all through his life. Now Jesus, receiving the Spirit, he says he will give it to the disciples so that they would be filled with the Holy Spirit and in turn they would communicate their Spirit to others. There's a beautiful passage in the Gospel of St. John where it says, "Let anyone who is thirsty come to me, and let the one who believes in me drink. As the scripture has said, out of the believer's heart shall flow rivers of living water." And John comments saying, Jesus was speaking about the Holy Spirit which he was about to give. He was not yet been given because Jesus was not risen. Therefore, Holy Spirit is the gift of the risen Christ. And that's the reason why on the day of first apparition on the Paschal evening, he breathes on them and says, "Receive the Holy Spirit." And he gives the mandate to forgive the sins through the power of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is at work in us, my dear brothers and sisters. This Spirit pleads from the side of God, asking us, listen to the Spirit. Listen to what the Spirit is saying to the churches in the book of Revelation. The Spirit is saying to the churches on behalf of God. But also the Spirit pleads together with our Spirit to the Father with sighs deep, too deep to understand, searching all the recesses of our spirit and making known to God what we are not able to express ourselves, what we really need. So he is working on both the sides, on the side of God and on our side. My dear fathers and brothers, the studies that you undertake is something connected with the Spirit right through. The first reading also says the gifts of the Spirit of wisdom, knowledge, understanding, counsel, fortitude, piety, and fear of God. These gifts are especially true, operative in all of us, especially the preachers, teachers, instructors, because all these gifts of administration, to be the apostles, to be the proclaimers of the word, to be the evangelizers, to be the teachers, prophets, all these gifts ultimately come from the same Spirit, so that we collaborate with him and then make the church what it should be, really. The subjects that you are going to study, scripture, canon law, mission, missiology, they are all connected with the Holy Spirit. The whole Word of God, inspired, is written with the power of the Holy Spirit, and it has to be understood only through the power of the Holy Spirit. Other than that, you would be only seeing some literature and doing some textual criticism. Then, canon law ends with this canon, the last one, that the whole law of the church is for the purpose of the salvation of the souls.
The Holy Spirit is given to us for the purpose of the salvation of the souls, for the forgiveness of sins. Receive the Holy Spirit. Those whose sins you forgive, they shall be forgiven. Salvation is through the forgiveness of sins and through the communion with God. And Holy Spirit is at work. And finally, missiology is again the action of the Holy Spirit. The whole mission is taken forward or begun and taken forward through the power of the Holy Spirit. It's only after Pentecost they started moving to the whole world. Today, all the texts, for example, especially regarding missiology, especially Redemptoris Missio, dedicating the whole chapter 3rd on the Holy Spirit as the agent of the mission, making the church missionary, beautifully summarizes what is the real role of the Spirit in our lives. Today, if Pope Francis speaks about the synodal church, again, he is highlighting that the Holy Spirit is speaking through each one of us, and therefore we better listen to the Holy Spirit speaking to the brothers and sisters who are our neighbors. I hope you have had some experience of the Holy Spirit sometime in life where you said that aha experience. Well, I experienced the Holy Spirit. You may have to say that and testify. It is an experience of grace. I would like to share a little experience of myself as a kind of a conclusion as part of my research. I finished my licentiate, and then when I took the same moderator for my doctorate, he said, now I will give you the theme and you should work on that. I didn't understand what theme was it. He said, Rivelazione come autocomunicazione di Dio. Hearing for the first time, Rivelazione come autocomunicazione di Dio. Revelation as the self-communication of God. We hardly heard during our fundamental theology. And I had not taken many courses in the licentiate on revelation. But I said, no, I don't understand. Then he started explaining a little. I pleaded him, can you give me some book? He gave me the book, the last book, I think, the synthesis of Karl Rahner, The Foundations of Christian Faith. Plenty of it is written, but to swallow Rahner is to swallow iron pellets. You know, it's not so easy for a beginner like me. I tried to read and read, hardly I could grasp. Then he said, well, I suggest one more thing. You must make an appointment and go to meet Cardinal Joseph Ratzinger. Me, as an Indian, meeting a prefect of the Congregation for the Doctrine of the Faith. Yes, you must go. Those of you who had in Rome during that time, now he is no more. If you are asked to meet, go and meet Ladaria. Now Ladaria is not there, now Fernandez. How difficult it is to enter the Holy Office. You will be scrutinized right and left. But this moderator said, no, you have to go. I wrote one letter, wrote a second letter. Every time praying to the Holy Spirit, please answer my prayers. No answer. I wrote a third letter. Then I told my moderator, now you go and give the letter. Because you have been asking me, do this favor to me. He said, okay. Because he couldn't say no. I said, I failed. I couldn't get any answer. Then agreed. He took and gave. He was in the International Theological Commission as a member. Naturally, Ratzinger was then the president of the commission. Then after some time, the secretary writes a letter asking, come on this day at this hour. I was really in trepidation what to ask. I had prepared together with my moderator some 10 questions with sub-questions. Took my little tape recorder, not mine, borrowed from somebody, not knowing, with the voice really weak and feeble. He took me very gently, led me, and then said, I said, Eminence, I want to make a prayer. I prayed to the Holy Spirit. He said, Amen. Then he led me one by one, asked the questions. I asked one question with 3-4 sub-questions. He would answer all the questions in the same order I asked. Tremendous memory. He asked this question. Okay, this is what I see. Answering my questions based on the Second Vatican Council. That was my query from him, because he was one of the peritus, the council fathers. Before going to him, I prayed to the Holy Spirit. At the beginning of the interview, I prayed to the Holy Spirit, concluded also with the Holy Spirit, and I finished 50 minutes of interview. I could hardly think who was the future Pope. Unthinkable for me, for my stature as an Indian, going there to Vatican for studies and having an audience with the prefect of the congregation. I thank God. I thank the Holy Spirit. The prayer that I was speaking or talking to the Holy Spirit was received from the insight of Saint Augustine. Saint Augustine said, I preach the word of God through the power of the Holy Spirit, and you understand me, and that too through the power of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit that speaks through me makes you to understand. Is the same Spirit. That's why we understand each other. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, the Spirit that speaks through you as teachers, because tomorrow this education will qualify you as teachers, professors, or as tribunal judges, or as great missiologists, missionaries, the same Spirit who works in you will work also through your interlocutors. Listen to them. They listen to you. And you mutually understand. May the Spirit perform His wonders through you and in you. Let us rise and place before our God our intentions and petitions. Dear brothers and sisters, as we begin the new academic year today, let us place ourselves at the feet of the Lord and ask for His graces in all our academic endeavors.
Your response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we pray for the Pope, the bishops, and all the leaders of the Church. May they continue to motivate and encourage academic endeavors in the Church to support the mission entrusted to her by Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Most Reverend Dr. Peter Paul Saldana, the Bishop of Mangalore and a member of the Board of Administration of our Institute, who is presiding over this Eucharistic celebration. Bless him with good health and grant him all necessary graces in shepherding the flock entrusted to his care. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for all our Institute's office bearers and the teaching staff. As we begin the new academic year, bless all of them with the good health of body and mind, so that they may joyfully and efficiently fulfill their responsibilities in this new academic year. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
We pray for all students of our Institute, especially those who have joined this year to pursue academic life. May we all make the best use of all the opportunities to study and excel in our respective fields and prepare for future missions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
We pray for all the non-teaching staff of the Institute who silently and tirelessly work to make a conducive atmosphere for our studies and research. May they continue to carry out their task with zeal and enthusiasm. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
We pray for our generous donors and those who support us in various ways for the smooth functioning of the Institute. May they and their family members enjoy happiness and success in their jobs and in the task they take up in society. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, we have placed before you our intentions and prayers for the new academic year. Bless all the staff and students and all gathered here. Send upon them your spirit and bless them with your gifts. May all the study and research in this academic year bring glory to your holy name. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Lord, I offer my
use it for your glory. Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you for your glory. Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise to you as a pleasing sacrifice. Lord, I offer you
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Sanctify, we pray, O Lord, the offerings made here, and cleanse our hearts by the light of the Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, ascending above all the heavens and sitting at your right hand, he poured out the promised Holy Spirit on your adopted children. Therefore now and for ages unending, with all the hosts of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to his setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with the elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her beloved spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Peter, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Peter our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Is in heaven. Keep us this day our daily.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Is it time?
people in my heart.
I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them. They turn away. I will break their hearts of stone. Give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it
so shall I
Let us pray. May the outpouring of the Holy Spirit cleanse our hearts, O Lord, and make them fruitful by the inner sprinkling of His dew, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Dear brethren, after the Mass, we have the inaugural program in the auditorium. Auditorium is just below this chapel. Before that, we have 15 minutes of break. We will begin the program at 7 o'clock.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God, the Father of lights, who was pleased to enlighten the disciples' minds by the outpouring of the Spirit, the Paraclete, grant you gladness by His blessing and make you always abound with the gifts of the same Spirit.
Amen.
May the wondrous flame that appeared above the disciples powerfully cleanse your hearts from every evil and pervade them with this purifying light.
Amen.
And may God, who has been pleased to unite many tongues in the profession of one faith, give you perseverance in that same faith. And by believing, may you journey from hope to clear vision.
Amen.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to
Saint Peter, bless us as we pray, entrusted in His care every day. Teach us to have deep rooted faith till we meet at last at heaven's gate. We praise you, Saint Peter. We hail you, Saint Peter. Accept our humble honor. Lead all of us to your master. We praise you, Saint Peter. We hail you, Saint Peter. Accept our humble honor. Lead all of us to your master. Peter so bold,
a comrade soldier. You've been outstanding, show no fear. A leader of the church you were chosen to be. Strength and power set your spirit free. St. Peter so bold, a comrade soldier. You've been outstanding, show no fear. A leader of the church you were chosen to be. Strength and power set your spirit free. We praise you, St. Peter. We hail you, St. Peter. Accept the humble honor. Lead all of us to your master. We praise you, St. Peter. We hail you, St. Peter. Accept the humble honor. Lead all of us to your master.